Guys, welcome back to the channel. Mystic is here today, and we are back with Mora, as you can see. And I know I have not recorded for like ages, but I am back after a couple months. I know, right? So consistent of me. But I need to like have a new microphone because this one is literally about to break, and if it does, because these headphones are getting a little crazy. So we're back with Mora. In my last episode, I'm pretty sure I said that we were gonna scavenge. In this episode, the episode after this one that I upload, that you guys are watching right now, I'm going to have us roll the dice for the power outage. That is it. The power outage is going to be either the next episode or the next one after that. There's no ifs, ands, or buts. The power outage is going to be happening very soon, because this is already like the fourth episode or part, and I do want to make at least like 20 parts or more. So this is Mora, and if you guys want me to upload anything else, just let me know and I will definitely do that. So yeah, basically, if you guys have any ideas, you want to see anything else from me, then I will do that. Alright, so this is Mora. Basically, we have like friends and companions that we've added to our household. And we were gonna give them makeovers. Yeah, we're gonna have to add them, train them, give them makeovers and everything. And we're going to need to like find probably like beds for them and other resources, because they're gonna take up a lot of space, an awful lot of space, and we're gonna need stuff for them. So Mora's just chatting.
Do this in bar.
Gabriel. There was someone else that I wanted Mora to actually like chat with, but like I don't know who it was exactly. Because I, once again guys, I haven't recorded in quite a while. So if I forget a little bit, then yeah, that's the reason, you know? Like I've been doing things and going places and stuff like that. Also guys, I'm planning to actually make the next part of my machinima this weekend, sometime this weekend, and upload it sometime this weekend. So my second part to my machinima will most likely be out this weekend. They actually are going to work. I don't want them to have their jobs because it's a literal zombie apocalypse, and I don't think that's very necessary. So yeah, I don't think that's necessary. I'm gonna actually have them quit school, not find job, but like quit school, because I just wanna make sense of the zombie apocalypse, and also I want to make us our own school eventually. Anyways, so yeah, we're not gonna use the dusty old schools. I'm just kidding. But like, yeah, we're not gonna use the original school settings and stuff. Alright, I'm sorry guys, if I cannot talk on recording. Just now, I literally have social anxiety and I cannot talk without stumbling over my words and stuff while I'm recording and in front of an audience, because I don't know, I get so awkward. Please mind that and excuse that, because I'm still gonna make cool, fun content for you guys. And if you guys unsubscribed, what are you doing? Do not unsubscribe. I have a lot of content, and I am not putting YouTube anytime soon. It's not in my plans, so yeah. But if you guys don't like my content, then there's others that will. So yeah, but if you guys do, just enjoy the videos, and I definitely will provide more content.
Mm-hmm.
I like how Mora just said, yeah. Yep. So actually, I want to give them makeovers. Like, I want to give them makeovers, and I will be back, guys. I guess I could record their makeovers, or not. Like, I don't know. I'll record when I'm done. Like, I'll come back when I'm done with giving them their makeovers, guys. And basically, you will see them all done up, you know? I think I'm just gonna keep the people we have in our thingy, like in our group, our new group. Because I don't think it's very necessary to add a whole bunch of other sims, and we still have like a full house pretty much, so I don't think we should do that. So I'm just gonna keep the people that we have for now. Someone dies or some misfortune happens of some sort, then perhaps we can add more recruits and, you know, have more children or whatever. But that's for later. Alright, so I'm gonna come back after I give the Sims their makeovers, guys. So I'll see you in a bit. Alright, so we've got all of our Sims done over and stuff. The only Sim that I did not get a chance to go around was Gabriel, because actually he was not in our household and I didn't realize it until now. But he's not that bad looking. We'll eventually give him like a hairstyle and everything. But as for like everyone else, I kind of like redid them. You know, I gave them a makeover, a little touch up, nothing too like major, because I just feel like they would do just fine with like the regular little makeover. So yeah. I'm actually gonna have us like scavenge for stuff soon, and like maybe go out a little, you know, because we're definitely gonna need more resources and whatnot. And I definitely want us to be doing that, like getting resources and, you know, not like not having anything. Alright. Let's see. Guys, I've actually got an RV. Like, Sims RVs and stuff. The mod. Go somewhere, we can like sleep, have some sleep in here, and all of that stuff. I want to have more like chat with her companions a bit more. Like, let's see, who do you want to talk with? We can talk to Michael Bell, we talked to him a little last time. I definitely want to get her a best friend, like, literally, Cecilia, like. In the previous parts, I wanted Cecilia to like be her best friend, you know? Where is she? Yeah, Cecilia, I want her to like be her best friend. You know, I wanted them to like have a good friendship and stuff. But no, she had to turn into a zombie. She had to get bit right in front of her eyes.
Olivar.
Which is very unfortunate, but like, at the end of the day, there's not much we can do. Andy abusing him at that, he dislikes handing us. You know what? I'm just kicking exit because I don't know what he wants to do. I don't know what I want to do with these Sims. If he doesn't like handing us, I mean, I guess that's him. I'm just gonna clean the toilet real quickly. And another Sim turns into a zombie. Ronnie, oh my goodness. Is that even can't meet Mats, and that's so sad.
Oh.
Alright, yeah, we're gonna have to like scavenge for food and all of this stuff. Let's see.
Neshka?
Simonaseru,
I guess some people can sleep in the RV for tonight. There's definitely like a lot of less zombies at night.
Muji,
Gigi,
Caleb Moore! Caleb Moore! Let's see!
An attractive Sim. Do you not like how he looks? Well, that's...
Oh, don't blame him.
Gora! Renik was sore! Sickle, honey! Luck. Someone is arrow.
I'm gonna have her grab the serving of her toast.
Spell.
Ina, Trippna,
Dumbut, Shuna. Oh, Groga. Such
a
Sarki is Zupa.
Yeah, I don't know what we're gonna do about all of this. And once we have our school situation all figured out, they build a school and stuff. It's gonna be crazy because there's literally gonna be so many zombies. We're gonna have to do so much stuff. And there's gonna be so many Sims that I have to keep tabs on. Which is like kinda crazy, but you know, we gotta do what we gotta do. Mom's just eating her invisible behind eggs and toast because my game loves the glitch. As always. And yeah. So sorry guys if you also can like hear my like breath when I'm breathing and stuff. That's literally because my microphone is right by my nose. So if you guys hear that, just know my microphone is right by my nose and mouth. So like literally not my fault. But I might get a new microphone soon, and once I do, I definitely will hope that that doesn't really happen much anymore. So, yeah. For some reason, we literally have 3 Sims in the bathroom. Don't know why they're in the bathroom. Maybe that I'll have to use the
restroom. What? One genie.
Zachariah, get out of the bathroom so that he can go. What the heck? You know what? I'm just gonna fill his ladder because she does not want to budge. Like, I literally don't even know her name. What's her name? Alice? Alice doesn't want to budge. Move. Go get some food from downstairs or something if we even have any food. Because as you guys can see, we don't have much food. We have one spoiled behind fudge bar. That is very smelly now. That's wonderful. We really need to scavenge for food and stuff. Because this won't end well if we don't have good food and we don't start gardening or planting and whatnot. Because we really need to get resources and crops. So I'm actually gonna just have us get random veggies really quickly. This is gonna be my first and last buy. Everything else I plan to have pretty much just scavenge for stuff. We're gonna open a packet. Coming to the rescue. If I remember correctly, guys, like, Mora literally got adopted in, like, the last part or something. I almost forgot about that. That was wild, and that was, like, the only time, guys, my Sims have, like, ever gotten abducted. And it was, look at my game. Oh my goodness. This is literally just logic. Like, Sims logic right here. Anyways, let me actually just get a screen. I can't even screenshot it. Like how weird and retarded my game is being. Like, I can't screenshot that. That's not a wholesome picture. What is going on? Like, I have no clue. You know, maybe I can do like only part of her arm since literally my game is being insane. Yeah. I'm gonna just do a, like, illusion. Okay. You know what? This is good enough. I think. Taking that think very lightly. Because literally that looks insane to take a screenshot, but you know what? Whatever. Don't worry guys, we are gardening and we are going to make some moves and we are going to have some food. We are not going to lie. Have some of them sleep in this little RV. Maybe about just like four or five. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Just the fourth one. I think Gabriel is probably gonna be the fourth. Can you not go in? RV. If not, that sucks. Because that means you might have to sleep on either couch or one of the bands. So, I mean, I guess we can have, what's her name? Sienna sleep on the couch, and we have Gabriel sleep on the couch. And actually, Mora is feeling tired herself. So I'm gonna have her finish making this. We're gonna make food for our bees. Literally having fruit salad for dinner, guys. Enjoy fruit salad for dinner. Like, literally, this is what we have right now. We'll have more in the future, but, like, as of now, you guys are gonna have to just scrap some of this fruit salad. Literally, just pure fruit for dinner. Like, enjoy. Bon appetit. So, maybe in the future, I will make some compounds or something like that. And have certain Sims, you know, rest their hands there. Like, make missions, rebuild civilization, have plans about that eventually. And I'm gonna just have them, like, talk about stuff and establish things. I think that would be very nice. Alright, Mora, what are you doing? Where is he going? Oh, into the RV? Okay, cool. Yes, go do that. Wash your hands. Are you ready? This girl take an RV or is she taking the couches? You can take the RV. Okay, Gabriel, keep sleeping on the couch. Sienna, do the same because we don't have much room. And literally, this girl's a teenager. She can literally just sleep in one of the guest rooms. Like, one of our Sims are already sleeping in a guest room. Like, she is lucky. Mayo? Lucky girl. We got one whole small, compact, comfort, very nice, nice, comforting room to yourself. Like, how amazing is that? Like, imagine being that lucky. Yeah, and this girl, Mizuki, she's actually a teen, so I'm gonna have her just take this other big guest room because she is, like, the youngest. When you think about it, I should have them switch because Mayo is older, so she should probably have the... She's literally a whole adult. I'm figuring she should probably just take the bigger room. And Mayo has one all to herself. Slightly smaller, but it's whatever. And you know what, Mora? She has the room that she has always had all to herself. She's the founder, she's the OG, she is the protagonist, and she's gonna have the very best room, the master bedroom. Alright guys, so it's getting late for them. I will see you when they wake, because there's not too much of a point in just watching them sleep, I guess, and I can, you know, focus and dedicate more time on this part to other things other than just sleeping behind Sims. So yeah, I will be right back when they wake. Alright, so we're up, folks. Mara is awakened, and some other Sims, pretty much everyone else, woke too, and pretty sure they're very hungry. They're very hungry. And their needs need to be tended to very badly. So let's go about doing that. And yeah. Alright. Mara's hungry. So a fruit salad sadly spoiled. We have fried fish left, but I don't think that's very breakfasty. This you know. Anyways, I think we should make something like a breakfast scramble. Basically, just, you know, give us a simple, nice breakfast. Oh my goodness. The bills. Well, looks like the power outage is going to happen this part. Yep, power outage just happened. You know what we're going to have to do? We are gonna have to turn the tables around. Very much. Because now we will probably have to craft candles and make stuff and not literally just have our nice little lights and plumbing anymore. We're gonna have to like collect resources, and that is not gonna be fun because we have a lot of people and we're gonna need to scavenge a heck of a lot because we're gonna need a lot of water, a lot of electricity. And we could get solar panels, guys, but when it's not like sunny and stuff, or windy, we can get windmills, I think. If we're able to get windmills, we can use them, but we're only gonna be using them in certain conditions, as you guys, pretty sure you guys know that. So that's... Alright, so... Let's see. We're gonna have to change this. I'm sad. Alright. So, we're gonna be off the grid and we're gonna have simple living. So that means we can only cook if we have ingredients. Because let's say we're running out of food and stuff. Like, there's not so much food. There was only one person, Mara, and she came to this house and, like, there already wasn't enough. There wasn't a lot of food to begin with, and definitely not for like a whole full behind house. So, simple living, we're running out of food, we're gonna have to scavenge, and we're gonna have to garden and grow crops and all that good stuff, and it's off the grid now. So we will have to actually use stuff like solar panels and windmills and generators and stuff like that, and this is a lot of rambling, but I'm just trying to explain it to you guys what is going to be occurring. So, we're going to need a lot of stuff like that. There was also something else that I wanted to say. What was I going to say? Oh yeah, we need to craft candles and stuff because our electricity, no, that's not working anymore. We cannot use that anymore, sadly. So, I'm just gonna move objects because we need to place this on here. I don't know if we can. I'm trying to. You know what? Let's just put these windmill things, these turbines. Guys, this household is off of the utility grid. Objects that require power or water will not work unless these those objects are supported off the grid. Supplemental water utility may be collected around the world. Also, check out the off the grid category and build and buy for helpful objects and activities. Some objects that can create water and power utility, even while off the grid, are the wind turbine, water generator, dew collector, power generator, and solar panel. As long as household produces more power water than it uses, objects that use utilities will continue to work. Here's the big challenge, guys. Our power is off. My guesthouse. Scanlet is starting. The simple lot like acting as lots requires ingredients and meals. If you're ingredients, be sure to order some groceries or visit the grocery shop and finish it. I wish we could. But we cannot. You know what we can actually do? We can collect these mushrooms and make some mushroom soup, or you can come and get some breakfast scramble. That would be nice. Because if we don't have any breakfast soup. I'm not breakfast soup. I did not mean to say that. I mean breakfast scramble. Our mushrooms are ready to be collected and harvested. Okay, we can make that for dinner. Doesn't sound very appetizing, but hey, what can we do? We'll have some moments where we make fruit and like pies and stuff, but we need more resources for that stuff. We need resources to be making treats and desserts. So hold your horses, guys. So yeah, guys, we basically have all our companions. We have the power outage, which is we have all of our resources for we have all of our resources for the power outage. We have all of our resources to rebuild things. Well, not every single resource, but we're making progress. We're definitely making progress. And I am very happy and proud of the progress we are making so far. So if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up, comment, like, and subscribe. Look at Mora. But yeah, I'm gonna end it here because usually my parts are super long, and if this is long, I'm gonna have a lot to edit, but if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up, comment, like, and subscribe. And in the next part, we're basically just gonna continue. We're gonna scavenge, and we're gonna continue on our zombie apocalyptic journey, and we're gonna make more progress, as we have been doing. And, you know, part in the previous parts, and this part, and yeah. We will continue to be doing that. So guys, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up, comment, like, and subscribe, and I will see you guys on next video. Goodbye. De noche de día.